Hello up there, hello up there. Welcome to the annual Black History Show. So we have been planning, we have been rehearsing, we have been meeting for months now. And our main goal for the show was to entertain you, but also to inform you on the topics of social injustice, racial injustice, activism, colorism, and even the mental health in the Black community, which is something that really needs to be spoken about. So, period. So, without further ado, please enjoy the show that we put on for you.
When the Pharaoh cherry comes, I'm gonna leave you. I'm bound for the promised land. I'm gonna leave you. I'm sorry, I'm gonna leave you. Farewell, farewell. But I'll meet you in the morning. Farewell, farewell. I'll meet you in the morning.
it out in the morning. I scream, but she keeps on pulling. And even though she pulls her hardest, it never looks right. I try and fix it, but Frisch just gets frizzier no matter what. They always want to touch it, and they don't even ask. Sophie and all the other kids try and pull my curls, and I scream, but they keep on coming. And Mama says hate is a strong word, but I think I hate it. I don't ask to touch Marianne's hair, even though I want to. Marianne is pretty. She has these golden specks in every strand, and it's not too straight, but not too curly like mine. And when she runs, it bounces, and her skin is silky and smooth, and it looks like milk. I saw a doll in the toy store the other day. It looked just like Marianne. It had these big, big blue eyes like oceans and a fancy pink dress with frills and white tights. I asked Mom if she can get it for me. She said I should wait till my birthday because I have too many dolls already. I never see any dolls that look like me. Mama says it's because they're all bought because everyone likes them too much. And then she looks at me and she smiles and she says, I wish I could have gotten you one of those dolls before they sold out, but I don't think I want one. I think I'm kind of glad they sold out. I wish I could cut all my hair off and for it to grow back long and yellow like a cornfield, like Marianne's. But don't tell Mom I said that. She'd be angry, real angry.
Ouch, that hurts.
I said ouch.
Do you want me to stop with your head half done?
No.
Then sit still.
But it hurts.
What color breads do you want?
Purple, and then blue, and then green, and then purple again.
Great choice.
A girl I know has flat hair. How does she get it like that?
She probably uses a hair straightener.
Can I use one?
You know, I've always liked your braids. We don't want to burn away all this beautiful curl, do we?
Marianne doesn't have hair like mine. She doesn't even have to burn it.
I bet Marianne doesn't have melanin like yours either, does she?
What's that?
It means that your skin is full of sunlight.
It looks like I have dirt on it.
Now, I'm not going to have you talking that way in my house.
You want me to lie?
I want you to learn.
Learn what?
That dirt is rich. It helps the plants grow, and everything beautiful comes from the earth. You come from the earth, and so do I. Your skin is full of diamonds and rich dirt and all the colors of a rainbow.
Black isn't in the rainbow, Mama.
Well, when you mix all those colors together, red and orange, yellow and green, blue and purple, indigo, get us out of it. Big enough for them to miss it every second of every day.
If it was so big, why couldn't they just find it and glue it all back together? You told me to retrace my steps to find something I lost.
Well, freedom can be a real hard thing to find. Hides in places never affect the look.
Well, did they ever get it back?
In time, but it took them a while to get out of the woods. We sure aren't out yet.
Well, if we keep on walking, we'll get out of them, won't we?
You know what? I think you might be right.
We just keep on walking and retracing our steps, and we'll find what we lost.
Just keep on walking. Miss Clark said you made self portraits in class today.
Yeah, we got to use watercolors and markers.
She said yours didn't really look like you.
It did, just with Marianne here. Miss Clark never makes any rules, so I wanted to draw something good.
Well, I would have liked to have a picture of you.
You can have it. I brought it home today.
But that's not really a self-portrait. is it?
No.
Maybe you can draw me a new one.
I don't think I can.
Why not?
Well, I don't know what brown to use.
What do you mean?
Well, there's lots of them. There's chestnut, mahogany, sepia, brown.
This does seem like a dilemma.
Yeah, I don't know what sepia is, so I don't need to know.
Of course.
And everyone else, they were using peach because they're mostly peach and, well, I'm not peach.
Have you ever thought about how many choices you have? There's only one kind of peach.
I guess.
Chestnut, mahogany, sepia, brown. There are so many different colors.
I can make my own.
There's no rules, like you said.
Chestnut, mahogany, sepia, and brown.
And you don't even need peach. Well, you're all done.
Can I snap my picture now?
Sure, I'll get you some paper. That's a beautiful rainbow you drew.
That's what you said I am, right?
Exactly right.
Can you help me draw like a diamond?
Sure.
And I'm gonna have to leave lots of room over here for some dirt. And I'm gonna have a big flower and it's gonna be me smelling the flower. Mm-hmm. And then I have to leave room for here.
Sweet thing.
My name is Sweet.
Responsible for this that held down my foremothers and raped them and discarded them like rags. Everybody hypes me up to brag because my skin's lighter than a paper bag, but what they don't know is I'll forgo a couple of, hey girl, oh, it's like that, suck up light-skinned bitch, you wasn't cute anyway. To go back in time and erase the pain that created me, but then again, the majority of our race wouldn't exist.
Who are you?
I am Sapphire. Too loud, too opinionated, too emasculating, too sassy, too manly, too neck rolling, too stubborn, too hard on our brothers, too independent. Too much the reason Kyrie Irving didn't invite me to the all white girls yacht party. In other words, too black. But like Sisyphus, it's the boulder I've been made to carry upon my back, and it doesn't seem like I'll be putting it down anytime soon. Who are you?
I am Welfare Queen. My kingdom is the projects, my court is my 6 kids by 6 different daddies, and my riches come from the king of all kings, Uncle Sam. Or at least that's what they think. They don't see that in addition to the check full of pennies I receive, I have to work my behind off to provide for my family and still come up short. Secret is, I'm just the face of welfare, not the body. The body of welfare is the companies that make millions of dollars in profit and yet still get governmental handouts. I'm not gonna mention any particular car companies or banks that receive welfare checks a trillion times more than mine, and instead of buying Cadillacs, they take private jets and vacation at spa resorts. But that's neither here nor there. I can't wait until the day I can resign my throne. I'm sick of lending my face to someone else's body.
Who are you?
Who are you?
No, the question, my sisters, is who are you? Why do we continue to accept these labels people place upon us? Stop it. Stop accepting these labels. We have the power to redefine ourselves by not only declaring who we are, but who we are not. Because I don't know about y'all, but I'm definitely not nobody's mammy. I ain't your hood rat, I ain't your gold digger, I'm not your chick, chicken head pigeon, or any other type of bird. I am not sure—
Broad, I'm not your trick, I'm not your jump off, I'm not your yellow bone, red bone, or any other type of bone.
Tell him, girl, what else you ain't?
I'm not even your damn female. I mean, do we go around saying, man,
these males tripping.
I'm not your heifer, I'm not your hoochie or hussy, I'm not your shorty, and I'm not your thot. I'm not your beaver.
My girl don't curse, but I do. She means we ain't your bitch.
Slut or garden.
She means your hoe.
I'm not your tragic mulatto.
I'm not your sapphire. I'm not your welfare queen or Jezebel.
Then who are you?
I am a woman.
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 Let the whole world hear that
I am a woman. A black woman to be exact and nothing less.
Maybe not the type that you imagine.
Cause we ain't reached your mountaintop.
But let me remix Frederick Douglass for a moment. Judge a man.
Strike man, put woman.
Not by the heights on which he has risen.
Strike he, put she.
But from the depths on which he has climbed.
Strike he, put she.
New sentence reads.
Judge a woman, not by the heights in which she has risen, but from the depths in which she has climbed. Me and my sisters will continue to climb from the bottom of the totem pole in which you have placed us to the top where we truly belong. See, society marks us as the bottom of the totem pole, supposedly because we are weak.
But the real reason is the strength in our feet.
We will climb, declaring I am a woman for every black woman that's been stripped of her humanity.
For every black woman that doesn't realize that her perfectly imperfect self is the reflection of God, we climb for you.
For every black woman that's a single mother, that's doing all she can to provide for her family, we climb for you.
For every black woman abused, forgotten, who feels like the glass ceiling of failure is unbreakable, we climb for you.
For every black woman in America disillusioned with how we are treated, we will get to the promised land one day. Follow our lead.
Keep climbing.
Oh! remember how I got the bullhorn in the first place? I mean, honestly, I was just as surprised as... I mean, there were so many people. So many bodies, you know? I'm talking elbows, knees, arms, legs, and everyone was pressing in, like... And then at one point, I looked down, and there it was.
My roommate was shy, was like, "Are you going to the march?" And I was like, "What march? Nah, man, I'm watching YouTube." And he gave me a look like, "Really, dude? YouTube? The Million Hoodie March," he said, "for Trayvon Martin." And clearly, I didn't make the right face because he followed up with, "A black boy gets shot in the city street in the land of the free and the home of the brave. You're just gonna sit it out because you think it has nothing to do with you?" I still didn't make the right face. "Nah, man, we're going downtown." And he literally grabbed me by the arm, pulled me out of my chair, down the hallway, and to the front door. "Rashad, man, I got a thesis to write." To which he followed up with, "Jeremy, man, you ain't writing your thesis. You're fooling around." And I was a little stunned because I hadn't known Rashad to be serious, like, ever. "Put this on," he said, and he tossed me a hoodie sweater. "Maybe this will inspire you."
And it wasn't like I had the intention of using it. I mean, first of all, it's not mine. Megaphone, not mine. And secondly, I was just there to support, you know, in solidarity. And then people will see it in my hand and they're looking over at me and they're like, "Why the hell aren't you using that thing?" Good question.
We pushed our way through the park at Broadway and 14th. And the first thing I see is this white guy climbing on top of the statue of George Washington. And I'm thinking, he's the one with the bullhorn? He's the one hyping up the crowd, this white guy? Please, we may all be Trayvon Martin, but we ain't all of us black.
And I'm being hoisted onto the statue, you know, the big statue of George Washington riding his horse, and I'm literally being pressed into his bronze junk, and I'm trying like hell to hold onto the megaphone with one hand, and wrap my arm around Blueskin's knee with the other, and then I'm looking down at the crowd, and then people are saying, "All right, white boy, let's hear it." And I'm racking my brain, like seriously stressing about what to say, because the last thing this crowd needs to hear is another sympathetic white person saying, "I feel your pain."
And this dude with the bullhorn starts reciting, "For my own protection, for my own protection."
And the first thing that pops into my head is this Essex Hemphill poem I'd memorized for a queer lit class in my junior year of college.
And I'm thinking, what in the world do you know about Essex Hemphill? Like, who even are you?
"I want to start an organization to save my life. If whales, snails, dogs, cats, Chrysler, and Nixon can be saved, then the lives of black men are priceless and can be saved."
And at first, I'm pissed. At first, I'm thinking, here we go again. Another example of blatant cultural appropriation. But then...
"We need to be able to save each other."
I'm looking around and, well, the people, they're listening.
"I don't want the Heritage Foundation to publish an article stating that black men are almost extinct."
They're listening to the words of a virtually unknown black queer genius.
"I don't want to be the living dead pacified by drugs and sex."
And they get it. They really get it.
"If humans can form chains around missile sites, then surely black men can form human chains around Anacostia, Harlem, South Africa, Wall Street, Hollywood, each other."
And I'm saying the words along with them. I don't even realize I'm doing that at first. Speaking Essex's words along with the white man, with the bullhorn, dangling from the statue.
"If we have to take tomorrow with our blood, are we ready?
Do our escrows, dreadlocks, and fillies make us any more ready than a bush or a cotton line? I'm not concerned about the attire of a soldier. All I want to know, for my own protection, is are we ready for whatever, whenever?"
And I lowered the bullhorn and it was silent.
No one spoke. No one even breathed. I sure did.
And then.
Poem is an exact transcription of what happened to Sandra Bland.
We're Detectives Highway Patrol, and the reason for your stop is... because he didn't, fail to signal a lane change. You got your driver's license and registration with you. What's wrong?
Nothing's wrong.
Okay. How long have you been in Texas? Do you have a driver's license?
Didn't I give you my driver's license?
No, ma'am. Okay. Okay, where are you headed to now? Okay, give me a few minutes, all right?
All right.
Okay, ma'am. You okay?
I'm waiting on you. You, this is your job. I'm waiting on you. When are you going to let me go?
I don't know. You seem very irritated.
I am. I really am. Because I feel like it's crap for what I'm getting a ticket for. I was getting out of your way. You were speeding up, tailing me, so I'm over and you stopped me. So yeah, I'm a little bit irritated. But that doesn't stop you from giving me a ticket, so.
Are you done?
You asked me what's wrong and I told you.
Okay.
So now I'm done,
yeah. Okay, you mind putting out that cigarette, please, if you don't mind?
I'm in my car. Why do I have to put out my cigarette?
Well, you can step on that now.
I don't have to step out of my car.
Step out of the car.
Why am I?
Step out of the car.
No, no, you don't have the right.
Step out of the car.
You don't have the right to do that.
I do have the right. Now step out or I will remove you.
I refuse to talk to you other than to identify myself. I'm getting removed for a failure to signal.
Step out or I will remove you. I'm giving you a lawful order. Get out of the car now or I'm gonna remove you.
And I'm calling my lawyer.
I'm gonna yank you out of here.
Okay, you're gonna yank me out of my car?
Get out.
Okay, all right.
2547.
Let's do this.
Yeah, we're going to.
Don't touch me.
Get out.
Don't touch me. I'm not under arrest. You don't have the right to take me out of the car.
You are under arrest.
I'm under arrest? For what?
2547 County FM 1098. Send me another unit. Get out of the car. Get out of the car now.
Why am I being apprehended? You're trying to give me a ticket.
I said get out of the car.
Why am I being apprehended? You just opened my car door.
I'm giving you a lawful order. I'm going to drag you out of here.
So you're threatening to drag me out of my car?
Get out of the car.
And then you're going to stun me?
I will light you up. Get out.
Wow.
Now!
Wow.
Get out of the car.
For a failure to signal. You're doing all this for a failure to signal?
Get over here.
Right. Yeah. Let's take this to court. Let's do this.
Go ahead.
For a failure to signal. Yep, for a failure to signal.
Get off the phone. Get off the phone.
I'm not on the phone. I have the right to record. This is my property. This is my property.
Put your phone down. Put your phone down.
Sir?
Put your phone down right now. Put your phone down.
For a fucking failure to signal. My goodness, y'all are interesting. Very interesting.
Come over here. Come over here now.
You feeling good about yourself?
Stand right here.
You feeling good about yourself? For a failure to signal, you feeling real good about yourself, don't you? You feel good about yourself, don't you?
Turn around.
What?
Turn around. Turn around now. What? Put your hands behind your back and turn around.
But why am I being arrested?
Turn around.
Why can't you keep
can
something
quiet?
I'm giving you a lawful order. I will tell you.
Why am I being arrested?
Turn around.
Why won't you tell me that, sir?
I'm giving you a lawful order.
Why
turn
will
around.
You not tell me what's going on?
Turn around.
I'm not complying because you just pulled me out of my car.
Turn around.
Are you fucking kidding me? This is some bull, you know it is.
Put your hands behind your back.
Because you know straight bullshit. You're full of shit. Full of straight shit. That's all you are. Some straight, scaredy fucking cops. South Carolina got y'all bitch asses scared. That's all it is. Fucking scared of a female.
If you would have just listened.
I was trying to sign the fucking ticket.
Stop moving.
Are you fucking serious?
Stop moving.
Ooh, I can't wait till we go to court. Ooh, I can't wait. I cannot wait till we go to court. I can't wait. Ooh, I can't wait. You want me to sit down now?
No.
Or are you gonna throw me to the floor?
Knock it off.
Better about yourself?
Knock it off.
Nah. That'll make you feel better about yourself. That'll make you feel real good, wouldn't it? Pussy ass. Fucking pussy. For a failure to send me, you're doing all this. And little ass Prairie U, Texas, my God, they must have.
You were getting a warning until now you're going to jail.
I'm getting a, for what? For what?
You can read.
I'm getting a warning. For what? For what? What?
Stay right here.
Well, you just pointed me over
I
there.
Said stand right there.
Get your fucking mind right. Ooh, I swear on my life, you are some pussies. A pussy ass cop. For a fucking signal, you're gonna take me to jail? What a pussy. What a pussy. What a.
I got her in control. She's in some handcuffs.
You're about to fucking break my wrist.
Stop moving.
I'm standing still. You keep moving me.
Stand right here. Stay right there.
Don't touch me. Fucking pussy for a traffic ticket. Doing all this bullshit for a traffic ticket.
Come leave right over here. This right here says a warning. You started creating the problems.
You asked me what was wrong. I tried to tell
you. Do you have anything on your person that's illegal?
Do I feel like I have anything on me? This is a fucking maxi dress.
I'm gonna remove your glasses.
This is a maxi dress.
Come on over here.
Fucking assholes, bro. You're about to break my wrist. Can you stop? You're about to fucking break my wrist. Stop!
Stop moving. Stop now.
Stop
it. Ma'am. If you would stop, then I would tell you.
For a fucking traffic.
Now stop!
You're such a pussy. You're such a pussy.
No, you are. You should not be fighting.
For a fucking traffic signal. For a traffic signal. For a traffic signal.
You are yanking around. When you pull away from me, you're resisting arrest.
This makes you feel real good, don't it? It makes you feel real good, don't it? A female for a traffic ticket. For a traffic ticket. Don't it make you feel real good, Officer Messina? I know it makes you feel real good. You're a real man now. You just slammed me, knocked my head into the ground. I got epilepsy, you motherfucker!
I got it.
Good.
Good?
Good.
Good? Should have thought about it before you started resisting.
Alright. Real good. Real good for a female. Yeah, y'all strong. Y'all real strong.
I want you to wait right here. Wait right here.
I can't go anywhere with your fucking knee in my back. Duh!
I'm gonna open your door.
Okay.
You need to leave. You need to leave. You need to leave! For a warning. For a warning, you're going to jail.
Whatever.
For resisting arrest. Stand up.
If I could, I can't.
Okay, roll over.
I can't even fucking feel my arms.
Tuck your knee in. Tuck your knee in.
God damn it, I can't.
Listen, you're going to sit up on your butt.
You just slammed my head into the ground. You don't even care about that. I can't even hear.
Listen to how he's telling you to get up. Yes, you can.
He just slammed my fucking head into the ground.
Sit up on your butt. Sit up on your butt. Now stand up.
All this for a traffic signal. I swear to God, all this for a traffic signal. Thank you for recording. Thank you for a traffic signal. Slid my head into the ground and everything. I hope y'all feel good.
This officer saw everything.
I saw everything.
I'm so glad to put that. You just got on the scene, so whatever.
I was.
No, you wasn't. You were pulling up. No, you didn't.
No, ma'am.
You didn't see everything leading up to it.
You know what? I'm not talking to you.
You don't have to. You don't have to.
2547 County. Send me your first available for arrest.
This piece to address the stigma of mental health in the Black community. She was raised in an unstable environment. Her mother was diagnosed as paranoid schizophrenic. This forced Sky to turn towards meditation, positive thinking, and creative passions like dance to counter this instability in her life.
See you soon. Can I get a little help here? Anybody here? Damn, I thought this was supposed to be fast food. Excuse me, Pops. You mind if I step ahead of you? I got a big order and I'm kinda in a hurry.
Yes, I mind. You ain't the only one with things to do. And I ate your damn Pops. But sorry, young blood, it's been a long morning.
No offense, my brother.
Yeah, I should've known.
Excuse me?
I said I should've known.
Can I get your order?
Let me get a turkey burger, extra cheese, Dijon on both sides of the bun, a 6-piece chicken nugget, and Dr. Pepper, very little ice. Oh, and a double bacon supreme.
You should've known what?
That he was one of them.
One of them? Really? Really?
Look, forget I said anything. It's been a morning, and I'm just trying to get home after work. I had to sit in traffic for 15 minutes because y'all had 14th Street shut down.
Pick up enough there, Bruce. I'll put it in the car.
This'll take a minute. We switching to lunch.
Yeah, well, sometimes you gotta take a stand.
Yeah, but it's how you're doing it that I don't get. People gotta get to work and get home. Y'all blocking the route ain't exactly the way to fix things.
What would you have us do? Nothing? Just let things keep going on the way they always have? Look, I don't really think this is the time or place to have this discussion. I'll pick it up in the drive-thru.
No. I've been wanting to have this conversation, so enlighten me. Because what do you want to accomplish?
Look, I gotta get this route to the rally so people can eat. I don't have time to-
If you can't explain it to me, how can you explain it to white folks?
I don't have to convince you or anyone anything. But all right, what do you want to know?
First, what do you want to accomplish?
Well, I mean, it varies from city to city, just as the needs of every community varies. But primarily, we want to put an end to our people dying at the hands of law enforcement, independent of the existing structures that allow our people to be gunned down in the street or die in police custody like our lives have no value.
Okay, I can deal with that part, but it's how you're doing it that I don't understand. There's no plan, no structure. Y'all just be doing things.
You may not agree with the message, but you have to agree that something needs to be done. The fight today is different because the system is-
Different. You say that like I don't know it, but y'all don't work with existing leaders or structures in the community. There's some folk with experience inside the system that would be willing to help. A lot of folks sacrificed so that you could go to better schools, vote, and live where you want to live.
Right, you mean like the politicians, right? The ones that kicked us out of our community for their fair share of condo kickbacks. They saw they had no control over the eminent domain, so they pushed us out of our homes for ballparks. Or do you mean the entrepreneurs, the ones with the luxury high rises, so they can play safe in their coffee shops and co-ops, with the view of the river because you know white people love water? Or do you mean the megachurches, the ones that told the poor people that their poverty is their fault because their faith isn't strong enough, so they tithe and they get that pass to the latest new gen? Or do you mean the old guard organizations that were on TV every day, the ones before Ferguson and Baltimore, that told us to be respectful and pull our pants up and turn our music down? Like any of those were the real reasons unemployment was so high for us. Man, even the president went on TV calling us thugs.
Are you gonna tell me there ain't no criminal element there? I grew up in that neighborhood. I graduated from Sumner, but I got out of there as soon as I could. I don't go back except for church, and after service, I get the hell out.
See, that's part of the problem. We know that white people don't give a damn about us, but it's you that I don't understand. You've lived there, you know what's up. You know if we call, they're not gonna come as quickly. And if they do, they normally just add to the problem, acting like everyone is guilty. Listen, I know you still get that feeling of dread every time those blue lights come on behind you. You telling me you've never been pulled over for nothing?
Yeah, I've been stopped. I can't say it was for nothing.
Did they let you go?
Of course they did. Had all the proper paperwork in order. License, registration, and proof of insurance. Why wouldn't they?
Did they say why they stopped you?
That they were looking for someone driving a similar vehicle.
So, hold on. So you believe that you didn't fit the description, but your vehicle did?
That's what he said.
And you're okay with it? Did they even tell you what your description was?
They never do.
And I'm sure you're okay with that too. Being stopped and not even given a reason why.
It's their job, man. If you haven't done anything, then there isn't anything to worry about.
Did they actually sell out the car?
No.
Right, not a fine upstanding citizen like yourself.
But if they did, I know the drill. Just be respectful, do as you're told, and you can walk away with a slight inconvenience at the worst.
Okay, I see. Your parents gave you a speech, huh?
And I gave it to my son.
And he'll give it to his.
Well, I hope that he doesn't have
to. And that's why we're out there. How old is he, your son?
Jabre, he's 7.
And you're giving the speech already?
With all the tension you guys are creating.
That we're creating?
I don't believe everything the papers say. But stopping traffic on the freeways, disrupting state fairs, blocking people from entering stores and malls, you gotta know they're gonna do something. They got to. You're messing with their money.
They're messing with our lives!
Not exactly our most valuable citizens.
Okay, I see where this is going. You mean like the criminals and thugs and gangbangers, right?
Like I said, not exactly our most valuable citizenry. If you don't look the part or act the part, pull up your pants, get a job, learn to present yourself in a non-threatening manner, treat them with the respect and courtesy that the office deserves, you shouldn't have a problem.
What about a 12-year-old boy playing with a toy gun in the park? Or a man shopping at Walmart? Or a lady being pulled over for improper lane change?
What about terrorizing a store owner just before being stopped, then resisting arrest? Or committing illegal acts in front of the store, then resisting arrest? Or running from the police after they told you to stop? Or making gestures that could be interpreted as threatening? These are all split-second incidents.
And in that split second, they always choose to shoot to kill. But in those same circumstances, the white suspect is taken alive. We're not talking about whether we did anything or not. We're not asking to be above the law for any special treatment. Brothers and sisters of all ages are dying in their homes and parks and vacant lots. Hell, even when we do get arrested, we just mysteriously disappear or commit suicide. The law says that everyone should get the right to be judged by a jury of their own peers. We're not even making it to the damn courtroom. You telling me you're okay with that?
I think you gotta be able to see a thing from one perspective. From what the papers say, you guys have declared war on cops. You block shopping malls, you disrupt political rallies, and you disrupt people's holidays by blocking airports. You'll never win the hearts and minds of people alike with actions like those.
There is no amount of empathy that can duplicate the feeling of knowing that as a black person, you can be killed simply for being black. In the 60s, America was shown footage of our people being brutalized in the South, and they marched against the existing laws. But nowadays, the media is getting so good at spinning stories, they put the blame on the victim instead of the system. And since there is no official legislation to go against, people like you buy into it. And we just accept business as usual. So every event can be justified with the, I was afraid for my life.
It's a dangerous job. You gotta do the thing that most people are afraid of, run toward the gun shop. You have to stand between society and the criminal element. Sometimes it's better to err on the side of personal safety. Sometimes you have to cut corners.
Cut corners? Wow. Okay, let me ask you something.
Go ahead.
When did you decide to turn your back on your people?
What?
Okay, I'm gonna put it this way. When did you decide to become one of them?
You don't know a thing about me. You best back the hell up.
How'd you put it? Not our most valuable citizens. It seems to me you think you're better than somebody.
I'm not passing judgment.
You know what I don't get? You said you lived here, which means that your parents' home is here. How much of their lives was? How much did that raise?
Leave my family out of this.
Why? Why is your family any different from the ones that live there now? See, we forget. We get a degree, we get a job, we get a little status, and we leave. We never look back. We, how'd you put it? Come for Sunday service and get the hell out of there. We go visit Uncle Wes and Aunt Dolores, and we wonder why they're still there. Then we start getting as bad as white folks. We start to feel ashamed, and we start to think, well, everything that's happening to them is their fault because they don't work as hard as I did, or they're not as driven as I am. So we start watching the news. We start watching baseball and football and whatever the hell season it is. You got mad because you saw that my shirt said Black Lives Matter. But for you, it should say my kind of Black Lives Matter. Does it really have to be your own son or somebody you know for you to care? Because your son is gonna give this speech to his son, and his son is gonna give it to his son. And it'll just keep going on that way unless we stand up.
Order's up.
We're out there for all the sons and daughters that never get to come home. All the parents that wish they said one more thing, because maybe the outcome would have been different. Maybe somebody cut a corner, maybe not. But think, what if one day is Jabre? What if one day he leaves and never comes back? What if one day he fits into the description and someone fears for their life and you never see him again? Wouldn't you like to ask the person responsible why? Wouldn't you like to see the tape if one existed? Don't you think everyone in America deserves that, right? Think about that next time you're in traffic.
feel like the world wanted me to stay in my little box. And black women often feel underestimated. And I wanted us to be proud of not only the show, but the process. Proud of the struggle. Thankful for the beauty that comes with a painful history. And rejoice in the pain. Rejoice in the imperfections and the wrongs that are so right. And I wanted everyone to feel grateful for their curves, their sad, their honesty. Thankful for their freedom.
Are we strong? Yeah.